In this video, we'll be modifying the comments system we created in the previous tutorial to use the Dodeca Comments Explorer, as well as adding a tool to our Views Toolbar's configuration so that the Comments Explorer can be easily accessed from the toolbar by our end users. There are two main steps involved in this demonstration. First, we'll modify the comments range configuration we set up in the previous video to enable the Comments Explorer and allow for threaded comments. Then, we'll modify the toolbar used by our view, My Report, to add an Open Comments Explorer button. Start by returning to the view definition for My Report in the View's metadata editor. Once again, find the Comments Properties category. And this time, set the Allow Comments Explorer property value to true. This property is pretty much self-explanatory, but it allows the Comments Explorer to be displayed by our view. Aside from this property, the rest of the changes will be made to the comment range configuration. So select the Comment Ranges property, and then click the button to the right to open up the Comment Range Configurations editor. In this tutorial, we'll modify the previously defined Comment Range Configuration commentary, but note that you can define multiple comment ranges for a view, and that each can be configured independently. Start by finding the Edit Policy property under the Behavior Properties category and selecting the value Edit in Both from the dropdown. This will allow us to create and edit comments as before in the cell on the worksheet, but it will also allow us to create and edit comments from within Dodeca's Comments Explorer. Additionally, we'll allow threaded comments by changing the Thread Policy property value to Threaded One Root Comment from the dropdown. This allows one thread of comments to be created for each unique set of selections within the view. We'll leave our In-Cell Display Policy property set to Show Most Recent, but now that we're allowing multiple comments per thread, we could set it to display all of the posted comments in the cell on the worksheet. Under the Indicator Properties category, set the Comment Indicator Policy property value to Excel Comment from the dropdown. This will allow us to quickly view all of the comments in a thread by simply hovering the mouse over the cell that contains them. Those are all of the changes required to our comment range, so go ahead and press OK to close the editor. The next step is to modify the toolbar used by the view to include the Open Comments Explorer button. To do this, scroll down to the UI Properties category and find the View Toolbar's Configuration ID property. You can see that My Report is currently using the S-Base View Standard All toolbar's configuration. Right-click on the property name and select Edit S-Base View Standard All from the context menu that appears. This will open the toolbar's configuration's metadata editor for S-Base View Standard All. Because we may have other views in the Dodeca system that use S-Base View Standard All, let's make a copy of it instead of modifying the original. To do so, make sure S-Base View Standard All is selected, and then press the Copy button located at the bottom of the center panel. Assign an ID to the copy. In this tutorial, we'll call it S-Base View Standard All with Comments, and then press OK. You'll see that the newly copied toolbar's configuration is automatically selected in the metadata editor, so go ahead and press the Toolbar's Designer button to begin modifying the associated toolbars. In the dialog that appears, select the Tools tab at the top to display the list of currently available tools. We're looking for a tool called Open Comments Explorer with a yellow sticky pad for an icon, but it isn't available in the present list. Fortunately, we can import standard tools and toolbars by clicking the Import Standard Tools and Toolbars button at the bottom left-hand side of the dialog. Upon pressing the button, a list of available toolbars will be displayed. We only want to import a single tool, so go ahead and press Next without checking any of the boxes. We also don't want to import any of the available pop-up menu tools, so once again, press Next without checking any of the boxes. Finally, you'll see a complete list of the tools available to import. Scroll down until you find the tool called SG Open Comments Explorer and check the box beside it. Now press Finish to import the Open Comments Explorer tool to the list of available tools in SBase View Standard All with Comments. Now you'll see Open Comments Explorer in the list. Now that the tool is available to the toolbar, we'll simply need to add it. To do this, start by clicking the Toolbar Designer tab at the top of the dialog. Now let's decide which toolbar we want to add the Open Comments Explorer tool to. Of the currently available toolbars, we probably want to place it on the standard one, so choose Standard from the dropdown. Then, simply drag the Open Comments Explorer tool from the column on the right and drop it anywhere you like on the standard toolbar. We're going to place it in between Print Preview and Send to Mail Recipient. Then we'll add a separator by right-clicking and choosing Begin a Group from the context menu that appears. Now that the Open Comments Explorer tool has been added to the standard toolbar for our new toolbar's configuration, we can go ahead and close the dialog. Before we commit the changes to the toolbar's configuration, we can see what our toolbar will look like in the toolbar's preview pane in the panel to the right. Finally, press Commit to save our changes to the database. Close the Toolbar's Configurations Metadata Editor and return to the Views Metadata Editor. Update the value of the View Toolbar's Configuration ID property so that our view uses the newly modified SBase View Standard All with Comments Toolbar's Configuration. Press Commit to save the changes, and then run the view by clicking on it in the Runtime View Selector. Now our end users can open the Comments Explorer for the view by simply clicking the button on the toolbar. We can see in the Comments Explorer that we have a single comment at the selected cell. By default, Dodeca's Comments Explorer is configured to display any comments along with their created by, date created, modified by, and date modified information. In the Linked By section, we can see the selector values to which the visible comment or comments are linked. Below that, we can see the Context section. When we set up our comment range configuration, we didn't set up a context string, but if we had, we would have used it to save some relevant data from the worksheet in the Dodeca database along with the comment. Go ahead and respond to the comment by pressing the Respond button at the very top of the Comments Explorer, and then typing a response in the text box that appears. Press the Save button to commit the new comment to the database. We'll modify a couple of properties to limit the number of columns shown here in just a moment. But first, let's see how our threaded comments are displayed on the sheet with Excel comments. If you scroll over to the right, you'll see the Excel comment indicator in the top right-hand corner of the cells containing comments within the comments range. By hovering the mouse over any of the cells containing an Excel comment indicator, you can see the complete thread displayed in a tooltip. This is convenient for viewing threaded comments at a glance without opening the Comments Explorer. Alternately, you can configure the view to display complete threads in the cells, but we generally recommend against this because the cells will expand by one row with each additional comment. What we will do, however, is go back one more time and customize the way our comments are displayed, both within the Excel Comment Tooltip and the Dodeca Comments Explorer. Return to the View's Metadata Editor one final time and find the Comments Properties category. Here, we'll modify the Comments Explorer Show Context property, setting its value to false, because you'll remember that we aren't saving a context along with our comments. If you wanted to do so, you would only need to change a single property, context string, within the comment range configuration used by the view. We'll also set Comments Explorer Show Last Date Time and Comments Explorer Show Last User ID to false, in order to remove these details from the Comments Explorer. Open up the Comment Range Configurations Editor by pressing the button to the right of the Comment Range's property value. Under the Indicator Properties category, find the property Excel Format and select the value User Time Comment from the dropdown. This will display our tooltip Excel comments in the following format: Username, Date Format, : Comment. The context string property can be found at the bottom of the properties table in the linking properties category. We won't demonstrate it in this tutorial, but you can specify the cell or range of cells that will provide some context for the submitted comment. This property value is specified in the same manner as the values of the address and key item string properties. This means that you can use a simple string, a cell reference, an Excel formula, or any of the above, supplemented by Dodeca functions. Close the editor by pressing OK, commit the changes to the database, and then run the view one last time. Now when we view an Excel comment at a glance by hovering the mouse over its containing cell, we can see not only the complete thread, but the formatting we specified in the Excel format property value. One important thing to note about Excel comments in Dodeca: when you're saving a Dodeca report in Microsoft's Excel 2007 format, the comments will not be written to the exported file. This is due to Excel 2007 to 2010's comments being stored in a format that fails to meet the requirements of the strict OpenXML standard. This means that Excel 2007 comments are not always well-formed XML, often causing the .NET XML classes to throw exceptions. If you need to save a Dodeca report as an Excel document with comments, you'll need to save it as an Excel 97 to 2003 file. Now, when we open the Comments Explorer, you'll notice that the Comment Detail columns have been reduced by 3 and that the Context section has been removed, giving us a little more room to display our comments. Additionally, like all of the dockable panels in Dodeca, you can move the Comments Explorer to anywhere you like within the workspace, giving you more room to work if needed. As I select different cells within the comments range, the Comments Explorer is updated to reflect the selected comment cells. So in this video, we modified the basic comment system created in the previous tutorial to use the Dodeca Comments Explorer by modifying some view properties and adding an Open Comments Explorer tool to the toolbar assigned to the view.